Now we get to some of the really good stuff, and this is why. Take a look at the drag and drop sorting activity I have here on my screen. Now I've got 4 drop targets and 5 drag objects, and I've set up the correct and incorrect feedback. And guess what? I'm feeling generous today, so I want to give our learners a couple of chances to get it right. A nice guy like that. So to change the number of attempts, all you need to do is head over to the design tab up here, and under the question tools, we can change that attempts to, let's just say 2. What happens next is pretty neat. Storyline automatically whipped up a try again layer for us, right? You can see that right down here. It's right above the correct and incorrect. Pretty cool, right? But now let's say you want to be even more generous and give learners 3, 4, 5, or heck, even 10 tries. Well, the good news is the process stays essentially the same for the 2 or more attempts. But here's the catch. That try again layer is the only feedback our learners will see until they run out of attempts and the quiz marks them as failed. Now, Storyline knows how many attempts are left. It's keeping count behind the scenes, but our learners don't have a clue. So we've got to step in and do that counting ourselves. And to do that, we're going to need a little help from Storyline's number variables to count each and every one of those attempts the learner makes. Now, we're not just counting the attempts for the fun of it. We want to show the learners how many tries they've made and how many they've got left. So think of it like a countdown timer, or if you're into games, it's like showing the how many lives the player, or in this case, learner, how many they have left. And because we're tracking those attempts, we can actually use that same number variable to dish out some personalized feedback for each and every attempt the learner makes. So it's a fantastic way to move beyond the nope, try again feedback for each attempt. Let me show you how it works. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is create that number variable so we can count the number of attempts. So I'm just going to head over to the variables, and let's just go ahead and create a new one. And we'll just call it counter. That's fine. We could call it attempts or tries, something like that. I'm going to call it counter because it is counting, but we could still label it as a attempt. So I'll show you. So we'll just say number variable, and we'll start by counting up, but we could also count down. But let's just begin this way. So the default value is 0. That makes sense. So counter, I'm going to click OK. And then I want to display that value here because that reference variable, to show the value of the variable, we need to show that value to the learner so they know how many tries they've made, or how many attempts. So I'm going to insert a text box, and we'll just call this one attempts. And with that, I can put a colon. And then I'm going to insert that variable reference. The variable reference just shows the current value of the variable. So we'll add a value of 1 each time the learner makes a new attempt. So with that blinking just off to the side like that, keep that active. I'm going to come up to the insert tab again on the ribbon, and this time we're going to choose reference. So reference just means display the value of a variable. So we only have 1 variable, so that's pretty straightforward. Say counter, and we click OK. So let's do this real quick. Let's just make this larger so it appears okay. So we show 0, and then this will count up 1, 2, 3, or however many attempts we get. And then I'm just going to put my cursor just off to the side of it right here. And I'm going to say out of, and what do we want to do? I'm going to give 3 attempts. Let's do 4 so we can kind of manage that. And we can always change that up or, you know, more or less later. So yeah, that's fine right there. And so now we need to trigger that variable. We need to adjust it each time the learner makes an attempt. And there's a lot of different ways we can approach this. I think one of the easiest ways is to take advantage of what happens when the learner makes that second attempt. So if we look up in the design tab, we can see we have attempts at number 10. I'm just going to set that down to 4 because that's what we want to show, the total attempts. So when will they see a second and third attempt? Well, they'll see that on the try again layer. So if I come down to the try again, each time the learner misses one of their tries, they're going to see a try again that says, hey, it's incorrect. Go ahead and try it again. So an easy way to work with this already set up is to add a trigger as a timeline event that adjusts that variable each time this layer begins. So here's what we do. We say new trigger, and I'm going to say adjust variable. So that's our our language that we use for working with variables where we want to change the value, but it's also the trigger name, adjust variable. And so we're not going to set the value of the counter to something. Instead, what we're going to do is just add. We're just going to add a value of 1 to the counter when the timeline starts on this layer. Okay? And that's all we need right there. Or we could add it when the learner tries again. I guess it depends on how you want that to work. I think the timeline makes sense, but we could also say when the learner clicks try again, then that's when that'll change. Depends on how you want to show it. Let's preview it real quick. We'll see, and maybe we want to change it back. Change it to the button action. Okay, so I'll go ahead and just drag one of these on here, and we'll click submit. So I can see my first attempt right there. Click try again. I can, you know, move it up there or just click it again. Second attempt, try again, and then we will do it one more time. 3 attempts, and I have 1 more try again. Now, here's my final and last try, right? And I click the submit button, and I can see the incorrect layer is telling me that I've missed it and did not select the correct response, but my attempts still show that I have 1 more. And so we need to make 1 little change, and that change is just to add the same trigger that is adding that value to counter. We're just going to copy that. I can right click, or I can choose to copy it from the copy selected trigger button, and I'm going to paste that on incorrect, right? Because what we want to do is just show that counter is now fully at 4 out of 4 when they get to this layer. So if we wanted to and not have to put it in 2 different places, we could start the default value at 1, right? So as soon as that interaction begins, well, that would be your first attempt. But they really haven't made an attempt yet, right? They haven't clicked submit or attempted it. So I kind of like putting it on the layer. Again, you're putting it in 2 places, but this will be the last layer they see because this is informing them that they missed the interaction. So here we go. Let's just preview this real quick. So just get 1 on here. I click submit. That's 1 out of 1. Try again. 2 out of 4. Try again. 3 out of 4. Try again. And then this one right here is going to be my final. I still missed it, but it shows me my attempts are full. And we could also do this as a countdown, right? We could, instead of adding, we could subtract a value. So we could say, if we were down here, we could say attempts 4. You have 4, and then we just change this value each time, right? So we could say, if you want to do it differently, well, that's the easiest way to do it. I'll leave it here, and I'll take that off, and then we're going to say, let's change the default value of our variable. So we'll tell them they get 4 attempts, they have 4, and each time they hit the try again, rather than adding that value, we're just going to say, nope, subtract 1. Sorry, I'm done like that. Subtract a value of 1 from the counter, and then we would just do it right here as well. Subtract a value. So it's going to be the same thing. We're just going to count down, and this time they'll see 0 attempts left rather than the counting up, right? So say 1, submit it, attempts 3, 2, 1, and now we have 1 last attempt to get it correct. Click it, and now it's back to 0. All right, finally, because we're counting the number of attempts, we've added our own variable so the learner knows how many tries they have based on, right, whatever we set up here for the quiz. Well, we could actually provide specific feedback to help guide them. So because we know how many attempts they're at right there, we can provide hint layers or additional feedback based on the number of attempts. I'll just do this once so we see it, but here's what it looks like. I'll make a new layer, and I'll just call this one hint. And I should have a layout for hint, so I'm just going to apply a different layout here. Hint. Right, and so here's the hint for first attempt, right? Let's say first attempt. Well, if I do a generic, I'm just going to say this is a hint layer. Hint feedback. And some general guidance. So what I want to do then is show this after they miss the layer. And maybe it's not the first attempt, it's the second or the third, right? So how do I then show the hint layer to appear rather than the try again? The try again is the default. The try again is automatically going to going to fire and show based on the attempts that the learner's making. So what we're going to do is we're going to still play off of this try again layer. So let's say when the learner is down to the last attempt, right? We'll give that last attempt and we'll give them one hint before they lose out. So we'll say show, we're on the try again layer. We're going to say show layer, and we're just going to quickly show that hint layer when the timeline starts on the layer if, and this is the condition that we're going to need, if the counter is, we could say equal to, I'm just going to say greater than or equal to the value of, well, actually it'd be less than, right? Because we're going to do it less than, if it's less than or equal to a value of one. So we're going to show that hint value when it's negative, when it's one, because we're counting down in this case, right? So we're counting down. So if the value is equal to one, I guess we really don't need the greater than or equal though. I guess it would still work with equal. Let's try that real quick. So we're say when the value is equal, show that layer hint real quick, and that'll be our final attempt. So let's preview that and see how that works. So we should see the try again for the first three attempts, right? So there's my attempt. There's one, two, and then here we're down to the last attempt. What happened to my button? My button disappeared. So what happened to that? We need to look at that real quick. Where's the button? Oh, there's no trigger. So we say hide layer. Not sure where that went. Hide this layer when user clicks. All right, let's try one more time. Might be an older file that I'm using, but it shouldn't be. Not that old. All right, here we go. Try once, attempt three, try again, two, one more time. Okay, I have no idea where that button's disappearing. That's annoying. So I'll make my own button. Sorry about that. We say button, and I'm just going to make a big old button right there. And then we'll say when user clicks the button two. Right. Got a little messy, but that's okay. So here we go. Countdown. I just want to verify that that hint layer is the last time we see it. So there's one because it equals one. We closed it. And now we get to do one more attempt and it's incorrect and it's zero and you can move on. So we could do things like, you know, I think it'd be easier if we were counting up, but we could have hint for attempt one. It could be hint one. I didn't mean to do that. Hint one, hint two, and hint three to provide specific feedback for each of the attempts the learner makes. We would just add those to the try again. We'd say show hint layer one if the value equals one attempt, or share hint two if the value equals two, and so on. But once we have that counter, there's a lot of things we can do that go beyond the built-in functionality. All right, that's how you can add your own counters to track the number of tries that the learners make. You can count up, you can count down, it doesn't matter how you want to go. Just remember to set the attempts number in the design tab for the quiz options to the same value that you use for your number variable. And if you're looking for a reason to practice this technique, hopefully you are, I've got some recent e-learning challenges on using number variables, and you can find those challenges in the link below. Share an example, and I'll feature your work in the challenge recap post.